Penguin Random House Audio presents Little Pieces of Hope, Happy-Making Things in a Difficult World, by Todd Doughty. Read for you by Denis Lambert.
Romy Nordlinger.
Angel Pean.
Rene Ruiz.
Alexa Sutherland.
And Jonathan Yen.
For my mom, Linda Sue Church. For her parents, Walter and Vivian Vaughn, 11/19/1912 to 5/30/1960, and 6/11/1923 to 5/30/1960. For her grandmother, Rena White, 8/31/1889 to 5/30/1960. And for Randy LoSapio, the Patrick to my David since 9/6/1996. And his mom, Dolores LoSapio. How this all came about. On Wednesday, March 11th, 2020, on the train home from work, I decided to make on Instagram a little list of happy-making things in a difficult world, accompanied by a photo I love as a reminder of the good things that surround us. I thought that others might enjoy it as well, and it'd give them a little piece of hope. The post was the first of what would become a series on my Instagram, at Todd A. Doughty. It also happened to be the day that the WHO declared a global pandemic. In the following weeks, as I continued to post lists, I discovered that everyday things mattered more than ever before. Feeling connected mattered more than ever before. And hope mattered more than ever before. For the past year, up through the moment you're listening to this audiobook, in fact, I've kept going. Each day or so, I curate a random, zigzag, scattershot, hodgepodge selection of stuff that brings joy. Everything ranging from short naps to a small piece of chocolate that leaves you wanting more, to an extremely green grasshopper, to Kayabot's Paris Street rainy day, to my personal favorite, as you will see, Lin-Manuel Miranda. You'll find some of those lists, as well as new ones, in this audiobook. Additionally, I've made you a few mixtapes, included some things you might consider doing today, and written a few longer essays on particular topics as well. Everything from taking the leap to living like It's a Wonderful Life's Mary Bailey. A friend of mine says there is a fine line between memory and discovery. I think she's right. While some items here may be familiar to you, others may not be. My list should be looked at as a launching pad for you. Go forth and forage. If you enjoy something listed here that was previously unknown to you, then we have shared that moment. Conversely, you may not like something on the list, and that's okay too. We all bring different backgrounds and history to the table. My hope is that this book will inspire you to remember and explore the things that bring you happiness, even if they're different from mine. And feel free to disregard things and add your own, so that this book truly becomes yours. Whether it's this particular moment in modern history, or a regular old bad morning, navigating the day, let alone the hour, can be overwhelming. But we all have touchstones in our lives that we come back to for joy. Family, friends, jobs, objects, memories, and experiences are the ties that bind. My hope is that you listen to each list, chronologically or randomly, you do you, and find something that speaks to you, or sparks a memory, or conjures a feeling of happiness and hope. The specificity of the items is key to the experience, such as that feeling when you wake up on the first day of vacation, signing each individual library card with your full name when you checked out a stack of books as a child, or looking back at old diaries or journals and thinking, who was that person? There's a rhythm and interconnection to each list, which I've carefully crafted for you and me. The goal was to provide a thought-provoking break in a busy day and a scary world. May this book inspire you to listen, read, watch, look at, spring into action, research, or remember. Another friend once said to me, Everybody is carrying an invisible bag of rocks. It's true. I have mine and you have yours. Each bag may be unique, but the experience is shared. However, I try to look at this in a different light. What's the one or more thing, person, book, movie, photograph, painting, recipe, piece of music, or meaningful object that got you through? There are thousands of happy-making things like this in little pieces of hope. If this book helped to lighten your burden for even just a minute, then we have shared a moment of hope and joy. In the immortal words of Lillian in the movie Bridesmaids, it's happening. Circle complete.
Happy making things in a difficult world. NYC. Fat goldfish. A really good burger. Long walks. Your foot sticking out from under a blanket in order to find some cool air. The music intro to NPR's All Things Considered. Short naps. Times Square, late at night in the rain. Sondheim. Someone forgiving you. Someone believing in you. A really bad DJ at a wedding turning into a really good DJ at a wedding. Stephen King's Twitter. Twin Peaks, Season 1 still holds up. College basketball. An unexpected phone call or text from someone you haven't talked to in a while, but just thought of moments before. An old gray muzzled dog with happy eyes. Any movie of Katharine Hepburn's, especially her entrance in The Lion in Winter. A small piece of chocolate that leaves you wanting more. Ella Fitzgerald's version of Irving Berlin's Blue Skies. A long road trip on a crisp fall day when the leaves are just post-peak and there is a scent of wood smoke in the air. An extremely green grasshopper. Lin-Manuel Miranda. The whistle of a train. Katherine Johnson. Newly sharpened pencils. Civility. Bacon. Eudora Welty's One Writer's Beginnings. Freshly cut yellow tulips. Kayabot's Paris Street, Rainy Day. The Trip Home. E.L. Konigsberg's From the Mixed Up Files of Mrs. Basil E. Frankweiler.
Let's keep it going. More happy making things in a difficult world. The pop of a log in a roaring fire. John Grisham's novel, A Painted House. A childhood toy or book that you still have. Any song of Loretta Lynn's, but particularly the bouncy rhythm of Out of My Head and Back in My Bed. If you've never heard it, you're welcome. That moment in summer when the light changes its slant and you know fall is on the way. Carrot cake. Those big fat bumblebees that look like felt toys. The feeling of accomplishment after folding a load of laundry. Ice cream headaches. The pioneering work of Jane Goodall, Diane Fossey, and Birute Galdikas. Handwritten thank you notes. Marching bands performing pop songs. Embracing the unexpected. Walking on a beach with your pants rolled up. Letting it go. Bear hugs. A good haircut. The poems of Shel Silverstein. A walkabout in an empty museum. Picking up with someone you haven't seen in ages and feeling like it was yesterday. Aretha Franklin's recording of Nessun Dorma. Holiday episodes of your favorite sitcom. Homecoming. A slow dance on a warm night. Blooming dogwoods. Old card catalogs. Lady Bird Johnson. The slap of a high five. the verbal shorthand you have with your college roommates 25 years later. Zion National Park. The Eudora Welty House. White, falling apart peonies.
Happy making things in a difficult world. The fact that Anna Wintour went to the movie premiere of The Devil Wears Prada, wearing Prada. Pitch black rotary phones. Jeter, Jordan, Lupone, Navratilova. 3-day weekends that you forget are 3-day weekends when the alarm goes off on Monday morning. Doc Martens. Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. My Favorite Things gets a lot of holiday airplay. However, it's not a Christmas song, but has lovely lyrics nonetheless. A really comfy heather gray hoodie whose strings you can tug on absentmindedly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.